Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Twitter at JRFromPTC. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about how to create a knockout using the advanced blending options in the layer style window. Then we'll use the Photoshop timeline to animate the knockout. The knockout option allows you to turn a layer into something similar to a mask. It's a layer that punches through all the layers below it, and it reveals the bottommost layer. Unlike masks, you can apply layer styles to these knockout layers to create more interesting effects. This is not a new feature in Photoshop. It's been around forever. In fact, when I first started using Photoshop back in version 7, this feature was already available. This animation is one of the first things that I ever created in Photoshop. It's a knockout animation using a photo of me as a 19-year-old around 2002 and a photo of a Terminator head. This animation was created using pretty much the same techniques I'm about to share with you today. The only difference is that back in those days, Photoshop did not have the timeline panel available, so you had to use a now discontinued program called Image Ready to animate the knockout layer. But anyway, let's get started with the tutorial. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to explain to you how the knockout feature works using this simple graphic, and then we'll move on to the more complicated project. So just to quickly show you what I have going on here, I'm going to talk about the layers that are found in this image. So we have a background layer, and it's filled with the color green. Then we have a pattern fill. Then we have a silhouette of a dog and a paw print. Then we have a star. We're going to use the shape of the star as our knockout layer. Let me double click on the side of the layer here to bring up the layer style window, and this is going to reveal the advanced blending options. Notice this drop down here, knockout. It's currently set to none. If I switch this to deep, then bring the fill opacity down to zero, you'll see that our star is now green. I'm going to press OK. But why is the star green? The star is green because it's using the pixels found in the layer as a mask, and it's punching a hole through all the layers all the way to the background layer. Notice that the background layer is currently green. If I, for example, add a filter such as the fibers filter and just press OK, notice what happens there. Our background layer changed. If I disable the visibility of all the layers, this is what our background looks like now. I enable all those layers again, click on the star, and move that around, you will notice that the star is punching a hole through all the layers, all the way down to the background layer. What if we don't have a background layer? Let me click on this lock here to disable it, and notice that now these are transparent pixels. So I can click on the star and move it around, and you'll see that we get nothing but transparent pixels. If you don't have a background layer and you want to create one, you can go into Layer, New, Background from Layer. And now the background is back, and we can move that around. What if we want to make the dog the layer that this star reveals? Well, you need to put things into a group. You can select the star, which is your knockout layer, and select the paw print by holding shift. So now these two are selected. And I'm going to put those two into a group. Control G, Command G on the Mac. Now, the layer that's immediately following the group is the dog layer. So I'm going to open this up, double click on the side of the layer here, and instead of using deep for my knockout, I'm going to choose shallow. And notice that the star disappears. And by the way, that particular star layer, we can also add layer style. So let me just add a stroke layer so we can see it. And I'm going to press OK. If I click on star and drag it around, notice that now the star reveals the dog layer. What if instead of revealing the dog layer, you want to reveal the pattern fill? Well, you can click on the dog, drag that layer onto the group. Now, the layer that's immediately after the group is the pattern fill layer, and that's going to be used as the layer to reveal by the knockout layer, which is the star. So I'm going to click on the star. I'm going to click and drag that over our shapes, and you'll see that the star now reveals that layer. So these are the basics of how the knockout advanced blending options work. Shallow reveals the layer that's immediately following the group that the knockout layer is in deep reveals the background layer. So if you're going to use deep, make sure you have a background layer. And obviously, if you're going to use shallow, make sure that you're going to have a group sort of like I have here. So I'm just going to press OK. And now we're going to move on to the project that you saw in the introduction. We have three layers. The background layer is not that important. We're going to use this stock photo of this man and this photograph of a skull that I took. So if you want to follow along, I do have the skull available for download on my website, photoshoptrainingchannel.com or ptcvids.com. They both get you to my website. If you're on YouTube, you can look at the description for this video and the link will be there. And once you open up the skull file, you may have to make some adjustments to the image. Maybe you need to distort it a little bit to match your skull. If you don't have a picture of a face, you can take a selfie with your cell phone. Just make sure it's a similar angle as the skull. And you can adjust it accordingly to match the head that you're using. And by the way, I've already done that in this case. That way we just work on the actual knockout method and not so much on distortions and liquefying and things like that. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the skull layer and click and drag that down below the layer of the man because the skull needs to be below that. Then I'm going to create a layer which we're going to use as our knockout layer. So I'm simply going to create an ellipse. Using the ellipse tool, I'm going to use a shape. I could also use pixels if I wanted to, but shape is going to be good for this tutorial. I'm going to click and drag and hold shift to create a perfect circle. The color is really not that important. I have black. I'm going to click and move that around and place it on top of the man here. And if you remember from earlier, what we have to do is put this knockout layer, and I'll actually call that knockout layer. You have to put this knockout layer and the layer of the man in the same group. So I'm going to select both of them by holding shift and clicking on both, then pressing Control G, Command G on the Mac. They're both now in a group. I'm going to click on the knockout layer and actually double click on the side to bring up the layer style window. Under the advanced blending options, under knockout, I'm going to select shallow. Nothing's going to happen, but that's okay. I got to bring down the fill opacity down. And now we can see the skull below that layer. Now that we're here, we're going to add some layer styles. So I'm just going to add a stroke. And by the way, the stroke I'm using is a gradient stroke from black to white. And I can adjust the scale. I'm also going to add a bevel and emboss just to give that ring a little bit more shape. Maybe click on contour and adjust it accordingly just to, again, give it more shape. I'm also going to add a drop shadow. The color of the shadow will be a color that's found in the darker areas of this image. Maybe even darken it up a little bit. So something like that. And multiply is fine as the blend mode. Adjust the opacity and the size and distance. And you can click and drag it if you want to, but this is a good spot for me. And I'm going to also show you that you can add a color overlay if you want to, and maybe switch it to color and maybe even green to create sort of a x-ray effect, but I'm not going to do that in this case. I'm just going to disable the color overlay, but I wanted to show you that you could do that if you wanted to. I'm going to press OK. And now if I click and move this around, you will see the knockout effect. Now there's one problem, the finger. We can do two things. We can either find an image of a skeleton and use a skeleton's finger and composite that in here so that when we hover over it, we see the bones of a finger. But in this case, we're not going to do that. We're actually going to pretend like the finger is just a little bit further away from his mouth, and you could actually fit this glass in between his mouth and his finger. And I'm going to show you how you would go about creating that effect. It's actually quite simple. All you need to do is click on the man layer and make a selection. I'm going to see if the quick selection tool works and just make a quick selection around his finger, and that selection seems to be pretty good. Just to refine it a little bit, I'm going to click on refine edge, and it's a little jaggy, so I'm going to smooth it a little bit and maybe shift the edge down just a tiny bit. So maybe something like this will work, and I can actually zoom in just to make sure things are going to work. And Actually, you know what? I'm going to go into the quick mask mode. So I can either press Q or click on this icon here and paint with white in areas that I want to keep. There's a few areas there that I think I want to keep. And you can paint with black to remove areas. So anything that's in red will be removed. Okay, so I'm going to press the Q key this time to go back into the normal view. And I'm just going to press Ctrl-J, Command-J on the Mac on the man layer to create a layer that only contains a finger. I'm going to put that in the very top of the group, and I'm going to call it finger. And I'm also going to zoom out just so you can see what's going on. And I'm going to press V on the keyboard to select the Move tool. Now I can click and drag the knockout layer around, and you'll see what happens when we go over the area with the finger. The finger's now on top. So that's how you would create that effect, just by stacking different layers on top of each other. Also, I want to point out, since we are using a shape layer, I can click on the Properties panel. If I click on this icon here, which is the mask, I can feather it and actually limit disable the effects just so you can see what's going on. I could feather it like so. So you can create a really interesting effect. You can see there. And I could also bring the density, but I don't think the density is going to do much in this case. I can bring the opacity down, and that will also create a very interesting effect, as you can see there. So I'm just going to bring the opacity back up, and I'll bring the feather back to zero, and I'll enable the effects so I can click and drag this around. Now we're going to work on creating the animation, and there's several ways of doing it in Photoshop these days. Back when I created the image I showed you earlier with Photoshop 7, we didn't have the timeline window. Now we do. So this is going to be one thing that I didn't do back then to create this effect. So I'm going to go into Window, Timeline, and we have the timeline. There's two different options. There's Video Timeline and Create Frame Animation. You can do it with either of those. They're different techniques, but they both will work. I already have a video where I showed how to use the video timeline for an animated GIF. So since I already have that, I'm going to use this video to show you how to use the Create Frame Animation. So I'm going to click on Create Frame Animation. And the way this works is we're going to have different frames, and each frame is going to be a different step of the circle moving around. And we're just going to play it. And once it plays, it'll look like if it's moving in a circle. So where do you want your first frame to start? It really doesn't matter for me. We'll just start here. And by the way, right now that I did this, I just remembered that I skipped a step, but that's okay. Notice how when I hover over to this side, we have white and not the background. This effect would be much more realistic if the background was the same for the skull. So what we could do is duplicate this man layer, click on it, press Ctrl J, Command J, click and drag the duplicate copy under the skull. And right now it's a smart object. I'm just going to rasterize it so it's a regular layer. And I'm going to disable the other layers. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly create a selection around his face. Like so. And I'm going to fill that with Content Aware. To bring up the fill window, you can hold Shift and Backspace. Or you can go into Edit, Fill. Then I'm going to press OK. And Photoshop did a very good job of removing the head, which is what I wanted. And now I can enable the other layers again. And notice what happens now that I move the knockout layer around with the Move tool. We have the original background, so it looks a lot more realistic. So sorry about that, I sort of missed that step, but that's okay. And now getting back to the timeline, we gotta decide where we're gonna place the first frame. So for me, it's gonna be right here, somewhere on this left eye. Then I can add a new frame and move that around. So maybe this will move up here, add a new frame, and maybe it goes up way up here, add a new frame, then it goes here. So you can think of this as stop motion animation in a way. So I'm just creating each individual frame and how it's going to move around the image we created. and I started here, so I think this one will be okay. So now let's test and see what happens when we play this. See this little play button here? You can just click on it and it will play that animation. But we want it to loop forever. So right here where it says once, we can click on that and choose forever. Then click on play. It's going to do that motion. And it's a little too fast. So why don't we slow it down? So I'm going to click on the first frame, hold shift, click on the last one. And then on this down pointing arrow, select something like 0.5 seconds and play it and see how that looks. And that's a little too slow. So we'll select all of them again. And click on the down pointing arrow and choose maybe 0.2 seconds and click on play. And I think that looks much better. So we'll just go with that. And you can spend more time on the animation if you want. For this tutorial, I think it'll be good enough. You got the idea. Now I'm going to show you how you can export this as an animated GIF. It's actually very simple. All you do is press Control Alt Shift S, Command Option Shift S on the Mac to bring up Save for the Web. If you're on a new version of Photoshop, you can also find it under the Export menu, Save for the Web. If you're on an older version of Photoshop that is not CC 2015, this menu will be out here somewhere, but it's easier to just use the keyboard shortcut. So the image is really big. Right now it's 1920 by 1080. That's way too big for an animated GIF. So why don't we just make that 400 pixels? Then for the file type, just choose GIF and we can play just to see how it looks. And that looks pretty good. I can stop it and you can choose how many times the animation is going to loop. Forever is the option that I want. So that's already set. And I can just click on this save button and then you can decide what to call the file and where to save it in your computer. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you have any comments or questions, leave them down below. If you enjoy the tutorial, don't forget to click that like button and share this video with a friend. If you haven't already, subscribe to the Photoshop Training Channel now. Thank you for watching and I'll talk to you again soon.